Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Today I thought it'd be fun to go through some more things brands do that annoy us because I thought the last video was enjoyable, everyone seemed to enjoy it and have a good laugh about it. And of course I asked you over on Instagram what things annoy you and I got so many replies this time and some of them were really, really good. So I'm gonna do a skincare routine. My skin's a little bit destroyed at the moment by a certain brand of product that I'm trying right now. So I'm doing a very typical morning simple routine. So I'm going to start off with my micellar water because I look oily right now, but I didn't use anything heavy or thick or anything that needs to be washed off last night before going to bed. So I'm just going to be very gentle on my skin. This is the only centella water I can use, the Bioderma one, that doesn't leave my skin stingy or feeling like tight, like I need to wash it off, you know? Okay, here's one I kind of touched on. And if you follow me on Twitter, a few of us have had a good chat about this one. But one thing that brands do that annoy me whilst trying to stay up to date and relevant and I guess like modern and just, you know, with the times is boring inclusivity. Now let me explain first of all that inclusivity is so important. It should just be everywhere nowadays, right? Everyone should be able to look at a campaign and see a version of them in that campaign. However, what do I mean by boring inclusivity? Let's take a look at Victoria's Secret's recent, more inclusive campaign. They basically launched a video over on Twitter and probably other places saying how they've been listening to their audience, they understand the need for inclusivity and they're changing. And this video shows all types of different people. It was good, you know, there was a lot more inclusive models. However, they have completely rebranded. I said on Twitter, their whole thing now looks like a Dove deodorant campaign. And you know what I mean? I feel like Dove deodorant set the standard for what inclusivity and like real bodies and real people look like, which is a group of everyday looking people in flesh or black and white colored underwear, standing together in a line, smiling, you know? And that seems to be the route every single brand goes down in order to be inclusive and in order to be like, we're an inclusive brand now. But what's annoying about this is people aren't asking brands to rebrand. They're just asking you to be inclusive. Being inclusive means including people of all types in your brand. So now Victoria's Secret have rebranded into this everyday looking underwear, swimsuit, I don't really know what they do, swimsuit underwear brand. And everyone's like, where are the angel wings? Where's the glamour? Where's what Victoria's Secret are known for? Yes, they were known for their very stereotypically pretty, tall, leggy women. People still want that glamour. They just want to see everybody involved in that. Do you know what I mean? Like, just because it's almost as if these brands think certain people of certain different abilities, gender, races, sexualities don't want to feel sexy in any way or can't be. Actually, it's hard to explain, but Savage Fenty, is it Savage X Fenty or Savage Fenty? I don't know. Do an amazing job at being inclusive, yet having a real stamp on their brand and who they are and a brand identity. All the models are wearing the underwear, the loungewear, the pajama sets. Yet as a brand, they manage to represent so many different types of people, themes, emotion, running through this more editorial style story. Some of it's sexy, the majority of it is empowering, inspiring, and yeah, some of it's joyful and fun, but most importantly, it's unapologetic, it's unretouched, and it's inclusive. But I feel like Fenty get it because it's genuinely a part of who they are as a brand and who they've always been. I don't understand why inclusivity means for so many brands means plain, boring, everyday boring. I get it. I want to see editorial. Do you know what I mean? I want to see a brand's identity inclusive of everyone. Inclusivity doesn't mean everyone and everything has to be the same. Treated the same, yes, but within who you are as a brand. Show us your new inclusive models in full glam with your iconic angel wings. It doesn't mean you have to scrap all the models you used before. It means having a good mix. Fine, it might not be everyone's cup of tea. I personally don't get the whole Victoria's Secret thing, but people of all types of an identity want to feel sexy and, you know, want to look good in underwear and want to be able to see them represented on TV in full glam on a runway. Do you know what I mean? I don't understand why we now have to scrap any kind of brand identity just to involve everyone. If that's your branding, fine. If it's been your branding since day one, that's great. A lot of brands targeted at Gen Z do this now, but there's just no brand identity anymore. Do people care? I don't know. Maybe it's because I'm from an editorial background. I don't know. And also being inclusive doesn't always mean just doing away with your slimmer supermodel models. You know, have a couple of them in. Inclusivity means everyone. Okay, next up, I'm going to go in with a very hydrating toner. This is the Claire's Supple Preparation Unscented Toner. Again, really good at just kind of getting the hydration in your skin, calming and soothing your skin as well. We have, of course, sodium hyaluronate. We also have like aloe leaf in here, which is nice and soothing. And then we have licorice root extract as well. I'm gonna make this bit short and sweet, but NFTs, listen, brands, don't do that. Don't do NFTs. No one cares in this space about NFTs. I don't know what they are and I don't care to know what they are. I especially don't care if a skincare brand is now selling NFTs, however that works. What this shows to me is a brand panicking and trying to stay relevant and modern, desperately grabbing on to whatever they think this new relevant trend is, you know? But like, should we do, like, there's so many brands who are doing like Instagram polls asking if they should be selling NFTs. I don't care. I guarantee that 98% of people that are into skincare who care more about your brand simply beyond what products you sell does not care about what NFTs are or knows what they are. And please don't try to explain it to me. I've tried a million times to understand what they are. Something about owning a really expensive picture that you don't actually own because it doesn't actually exist or something. I don't know. Okay, here's one I feel like everyone can relate to, no matter what brand you buy from, because pretty much every brand and online shop does this. Online stores sending you a single product in a giant box. I got a product, right, for a video I'm gonna record later. Here it is. Down here, the one product I ordered. Just there, look. Could this not have been a padded envelope? And you know what happens now is I've got to find somewhere to put that box now. Take it apart and put it in the recycling. And it's huge for no reason. For absolutely no reason. Amazon are so guilty of this. You order one thing and it comes in a huge box. Like, I can't even fit it on the screen, you know? And then just padding everywhere. At least, I guess it's like card and you can recycle it. But can we just get some padded envelopes and send it out like that? I don't know. Serum. This is the Ample N Ceramide Shot Ample. I like religiously use this whenever my skin is bothered, inflamed, itchy, irritated, because ceramides are just important for your skin's health overall. Shouldn't always necessarily just be an afterthought, you know, like once you've damaged your skin. Here's an answer to my Instagram question that interested me. And I get this. Brands that still treat millennials as youngsters that want avocado toast and not like 30 and 40 year olds. Yes, us millennials are no longer Pinterest, DIY, avocado on toast, boho chic. You know, friends watching millennials. We are also now adults with so many different priorities rather than just brunch. We've also learned a lot as well. I feel like millennials grew up in a time where, you know, not a lot was questioned, then a lot was questioned, and now we kind of look back on us in our 20s and we cringe, you know? We got like boomers ahead. Is it boomers ahead of us than Gen Z underneath us? And we're kind of like somewhere mixed in the middle. I like to think our priorities are more with the majority of Gen Z, you know? We kind of want the same thing. But a lot of brands still haven't rebranded, I guess it is. And this is why I think Glossier have started to use like Olivia Rodrigo, because they realize that there's only so much millennial kind of like advertising you can do. Like, millennials have grown up and we're not all obsessed with millennial pink anymore. And to kind of make your brand all around millennials is a little bit outdated now, probably a little bit hard to sell. I feel like it's the same with Kylie Cosmetics. I've noticed that she's also changed her font a little bit. She's been a bit more daring with designs and all that kind of stuff. And it's got that more 70s kind of vibe to it. I think it's just this particular collection. But you know, that whole thing is very modern design, very younger design, very Gen Z. But there are a lot of brands who I feel like us millennials grew up with who just haven't rebranded or moved along with the times. And, you know, they're trying to by like posting memes and stuff, but it's all very outdated. And that makes it look like, you know, like your fun auntie sharing memes on Facebook. Yeah, I agree. Like, I no longer want to see a bird's eye shot view of somebody's sunscreen next to avocado toast and a latte. Do you know what I mean? Here's one that bothers me all the time. But whenever it happens, I'm not surprised because I'm come to the point now where I kind of expect it. Putting false bottoms in pots to make it look like you're getting more annoys the shit out of me. I agree. You get these pots, right? They're like this. And then you just have like this tiny, tiny capsule in the middle of it, you know? You know what I mean? It's like this. I'll try and find an example. And I don't think this is just because the packaging looks good that way. It's honestly deceptive. It's like, it looks like you're getting more for your money because you buy a product thinking, oh my God, I'm getting this huge pot of product. And then you look at it and it's a pot within a pot. It's kind of like, it's deceptive. I feel deceived. Sometimes you can't even see it. So you open your product and you're thinking, oh my God, I got so much left. And then you hit the bottom of it, but the bottom of it is halfway up, you know, halfway up the bottle. And it's like, the pot, it's like, what's, like, what, where's all this, why? And in that way, I feel like they're charging you more for the product because you think you're getting more for your money when you're not. I tend to avoid sunscreen when my skin is sensitive. I find that it can make my skin itchy, almost prickly feeling. So if I'm going to go out in the sun, I will wear a hat, I will wear, you know, cover up. But just while my skin barrier is impaired, I'm going to not use products I know can potentially irritate. So I'm going to go in with the Rode Barrier Restore Cream, a nice lightweight moisturizer that is going to restore my barrier. Okay, I'm going to finish on this one because this is kind of like more of an influencer thing, but I feel like you guys know when this is happening. This is when brands don't give influencers creativity in the sponsorship. Yes, here's the kind of issues that I run into. And I always know when a video isn't going to perform very well because a brand will give me what they want me to talk about. And if I think it's an interesting topic that I can talk about, I'll be fine. I'll be like, fine, whatever. It might not get many views though. And they're like, that's fine. But I can literally be like, I will create a video for you using these products that I love in a way that I know is gonna get you views, click-throughs, you know, hopefully people will buy your product, and hopefully my genuine love for these products will shine through. But I think they have brands have people working for them who are like these marketing experts and online, you know, content experts, when really the real experts are the people who do this day in, day out as a full-time job. I had this with ASOS actually when I used to work for ASOS, the kind of team that would kind of like approve our content that would go online kind of had quite strict kind of regulations about how we came across and what we can and can't say and what clothes we would wear and all this kind of stuff, when really none of that matters. The reason influencers are successful and the reason influencers can sell stuff is because they are being themselves. And it's not about, you know, there's so many people who tell you, you have to do this for the algorithm, you have to come across as this, you have to do this. None of it ever works. None of it ever works. And I will tell you, the most successful people are the people who are just being themselves and doing whatever the fuck they want to do. So when a brand wants to work, with an influencer, I think, yeah, there should be certain points that they need to hit.
Hi, baby. Come in, come in.
Yay, Bishop. Oh, baby, you're sliding. You're sliding. I got wooden floor now and he can't keep up. What's that on your whisker? Thanks, baby. Oh, thank you. Oh, your breath's stinky. Your breath's stinky. Good stinky breath. You wanna get down? Got you. There we go. So I do think, of course, a brand wants you to hit all the right points for their new product, get all the relevant stuff in and all the important information, absolutely. But I do think they need to give creators the creativity, because subscribers of a particular influencer, just gonna wipe my ear quick, know that influencer inside and out. And I think when they can see that they're being told what they need to do rather than creating content that they're really truly passionate about, subscribers aren't stupid, especially as they have as much knowledge as how the industry works as the influencer themselves, you know? Right, I'm gonna go because my dog wants attention and I'm about to give it to him. So let me know your opinions down below. I'd love to know what you think about the whole inclusivity, what I feel was like an issue of like there being this kind of like set way inclusivity looks in brands. You're really panting. It's hot, isn't it? Let's go get you under the air conditioning, okay? Let me know what you think down below. You put some more videos here. You're gonna hear him panting so bad. Some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.